Climate change is one of the defining environmental problems of this generation. The Department of Biology at the University of Washington is meeting the challenge of climate change head on. We have a large number of faculty looking at the issues of climate change. We work at all levels of biological organization, from molecules to ecosystems, and ecosystems as different as the forests of Mount Rainier and the coasts of Friday Harbor Labs to tackle the problems of climate change.
We can get samples from tree rings going back into the past, and we analyze the annual growth rings. We're using information from the growth history of trees, from their past growth over the last 100 to 200 years, to try to understand how they might respond to future climate change. We have climate stations records that go back the same amount of time, and that tells us whether trees do better in warm years or perhaps worse. And if they started growing faster or slower, that would actually influence the climate system. In the state of Washington, many of the trees I study are economically valuable. So they're, like Douglas fir is one of our focal species, and that's a super important forestry species. What we want to do is take all that information on how trees grow and survive and reproduce under different climatic conditions and turn that into a virtual forest on a computer. And we play that model forward to tell us how these trees will respond to climate change.
Mussels have a really important role in our ecosystems. They're known as foundation species. They clean water and provide habitat for other species. In cooler waters, they are strong, and as it gets warmer and warmer during the summer, they're weaker. The concern is that it's going to get even warmer in our summers, and it's going to push them over the edge. In the laboratory, we have an instrument known as a tensometer, and what it does is grab hold of material and slowly pull them apart until they break. From that information, we can measure material strength and extensibility. Mussel fall off occurs when they have weak attachment. They're not producing enough Bissell threads, and they're not very strong. We're trying to understand what causes this fall off and give the growers the information they need to manage around this problem. We have some real concerns about ocean warming and ocean acidification. We want to know how that will affect things we care about, industries that we depend on, and tourism that supports our communities.
21st century biology should be addressing problems like climate change with the best available tools and the best people. We have to develop strategies so that we can predict those changes, we have to adapt to those changes, and we have to keep the planet habitable for future generations.